Have you ever wondered if the seemingly innocent website you're browsing could be secretly running malicious code on your computer? It might sound like something out of a techno thriller, but in the world of cybersecurity, this scenario is all too real. Welcome to our exploration of cross-site scripting attacks, also known as XSS, a subtle yet powerful weapon in a hacker's arsenal. Imagine you're at a masquerade ball. Everyone's wearing elaborate masks and costumes. You strike up a conversation with someone, thinking they're a fellow guest. But what if that person was actually an uninvited intruder, blending in perfectly with the crowd? This is essentially what happens in a cross-site scripting attack. The malicious code masquerades as part of a legitimate website, tricking both the site and its visitors. In today's video, we're going to pull back the curtain on XSS attacks, understand why they're so dangerous, and learn how to protect ourselves from these digital masqueraders. Let's start with a simple scenario. You're browsing your favorite social media site. You come across a post with a link promising click here to see who viewed your profile. Intrigued, you click. Suddenly, you've unknowingly given a hacker access to your account. This is a classic example of an XSS attack in action. Now, let's break down how this attack unfolds. At its core, an XSS attack involves injecting malicious scripts into trusted websites. When other users visit these compromised pages, their browsers unknowingly execute the malicious script as if it were part of the legitimate site. There are three main types of XSS attacks: stored, reflected, and DLM-based. Let's explore each one. First, we have stored XSS attacks. These are the most dangerous type. Here, the malicious script is permanently stored on the target server. This could be in a database, message forum, visitor log, or comment field. Every time a user requests the stored information, the malicious script is served as part of the web page. It's like a trap that's always set, waiting for victims to stumble upon it. Next, there's reflected XSS. In this type, the malicious script is embedded in a link. When a user clicks the link, the script is sent to the vulnerable website, which then reflects it back to the user's browser where it's executed. This type often relies on social engineering to trick users into clicking a malicious link. Lastly, we have DOM-based XSS. This is the most complex type. It occurs when the client-side script writes user input to the page. The vulnerability is in the client-side code rather than the server-side code. It's like leaving your house key under the doormat. The danger isn't inside the house, but in how you access it. Now, you might be wondering, what can these attacks actually do? The answer is, a lot, and none of it good. An XSS attack can steal your cookies, which often contain session tokens. With these, an attacker can impersonate you on websites where you're logged in. They can steal your login credentials by injecting a fake login form. They can deface websites, redirect you to malicious sites, or even take control of your browser. In more severe cases, XSS can be used to spread worms across social media platforms, infecting thousands of users in a short time. The infamous Samy Worm on MySpace in 2005 is a classic example. It exploited an XSS vulnerability to add over 1 million friends to the creator's profile in just 20 hours. But why are XSS attacks so prevalent and dangerous? There are several reasons. First, they're relatively easy to execute. All an attacker needs is a way to inject script into a web page. This could be through a comment box, a forum post, or even a URL parameter. Second, they exploit trust. The malicious script runs in the context of the trusted website. Your browser has no way of knowing it's not a legitimate part of the site. Third, they can be very subtle. Unlike more dramatic attacks that might crash a system, an XSS attack can operate silently in the background, stealing data or manipulating the user's experience without raising suspicion. Lastly, many developers underestimate the threat. They might focus on other types of attacks, leaving XSS vulnerabilities unaddressed. So, how can we protect ourselves and our websites from these stealthy invaders? For web developers, the key is input validation and output encoding. Never trust user input. Always validate and sanitize any data that comes from users before using it in your web pages. When outputting data, encode it to ensure that browsers interpret it as data, not code. Developers should also use Content Security Policy, CSP, headers. These allow you to specify which sources of content browsers should consider valid for your site. This can prevent the execution of malicious scripts even if they do find their way onto your pages. Another crucial step is to use HTTP-only cookies for session management. This flag prevents client-side scripts from accessing the cookie, making it much harder for attackers to steal session tokens. Regular security audits and penetration testing are also essential. These can help identify XSS vulnerabilities before attackers exploit them. For users, the first line of defense is awareness. Be cautious about clicking links, especially those that seem too good to be true. Keep your browsers and plugins up to date, as newer versions often include protections against known XSS vulnerabilities. Consider using browser extensions that provide additional protection against XSS. Tools like NoScript allow you to control which scripts can run on your browser, adding an extra layer of security. As we wrap up, let's remember that while cross-site scripting attacks are a serious threat, they're not invincible. By understanding how these attacks work and implementing strong security practices, we can significantly reduce our risk of falling victim to these digital masqueraders. In our interconnected world, every website we visit, every form we fill out, every link we click is a potential vector for an XSS attack. But armed with knowledge and the right tools, we can unmask these silent invaders. We can ensure that our online interactions remain secure, our data protected, and our digital identities safe. In our next video, we'll explore another captivating concept in the world of ethical hacking. Until then, stay vigilant, stay secure, and remember, on the web, not everything is as it seems. But with the right knowledge, you can see through the disguises and keep your digital life safe and sound. Keep questioning. Keep learning, and never stop exploring the fascinating world of cybersecurity.